Hey Flukas! Today we're giving back to the community in a day of service we're calling Hands on Fluvanna. In the next few minutes, we'll show you how you'll be lending a hand here at the school.
In your homerooms this morning, teachers should have given you a wristband with a certain color. 8th grade yellow, 9th grade gray, 10th grade green, and 11th and 12th grade purple. Be sure to keep these on throughout the day so you know where to go.
In this video, we are going to be giving you detailed instruction on what you'll be doing at each of your four service stations. So pay close attention. Here we go.
In the USO service station located on the left-hand side of the main gym, you will be assembling gift bags with your class for servicemen and women who are deploying overseas. You will also be encouraged to write letters to be included in the gift bags that will be distributed by Flukas at the Richmond Airport USO station. Here's a quick look at some of the ways USO supports our troops.
Welcome to the USO. Have you been to our center before? We would like to show you around.
Home. It's more than a place. It's a feeling. Knowing that you're surrounded by those who care. Being comfortable enough to relax. To appreciate the small things. To laugh. So when the road is hard and the journey is long, let this be a place you can call your home until you are home again. When you're half a world away from the ones you love, from the milestones to the everyday moments, you can count on us to be there, keeping you connected to those you care about the most. Because wherever you go, know that you will not go alone. From the first goodbye until you are together again, we will be there, bridging the gap between you and your family, no matter how far apart you are. This is how America shows its gratitude to you. Your country is thankful for the sacrifices you make. You are what makes us great. You are what makes America worth celebrating. Know that we will remain steadfast in our commitment to you. We will meet your needs wherever they arise. We are a family of volunteers here to show you that what you do is appreciated, that your service does not go unnoticed. We will always keep you connected to family, home, and country, no matter where you are and no matter how long. We are the USO, and we are here for you.
All the thoughts in my head spin around like a hurricane, and life leaves me so confused. When I trip and I fall, I collapse like a tidal wave. So I'm crying out.
You come to my rescue, you're the only one. When I'm hit like a hook to the jaw in a title fight, I'm down and I'm knocked out cold, you know. And if my heart broke apart like a wreck in a shallow tide, yeah, I've never felt this low.
So, it's easy to see how the bag you make today will go into the hands of someone that could really use a kind gesture from a stranger. From the USO service station, you walk over to
the Arlington National Cemetery service station, located on the right-hand side of the gym. Here you'll be making artificial flowers that will be placed at the grave sites of our fallen soldiers. Here's a short video to instruct you on what you'll be making.
Today you'll be making tissue paper flowers for the Arlington National Cemetery as part of Hands on Fluvanna. The supplies you'll need are scissors, pipe cleaners, and 5 to 6 pieces of tissue paper. The color does not matter. To begin, you are going to start folding your tissue paper back and forth in an accordion-like style all the way to the end of the tissue paper. Once you are done, your tissue paper should look like this. Now grab a pipe cleaner and fold the pipe cleaner over the tissue paper in the middle. If the pipe cleaner is not directly in the middle, you can move it. There are different types of ways you can cut the edges of your flower. You can cut them in a half circle shape, a triangle shape, or a freestyle shape. Don't cut too far into the flower. Now you want to fan out the bottom petals of your flower. Now, separate each layer and pull them towards the center of the flower. By doing this, it will give its layers look. Next, you can run your hand over top of it to fluff it up to give it more of a realistic look. Make sure to sweep away and clean up all your scraps from your tissue paper. Here are some examples of different edges that you can do. This one is more rounded, The white one is the triangle cut out, so it is more pointed. And this one is the more free shape. And there you go. You made tissue paper flowers.
Thank you.
As you can see, it will take a little bit of a concentration, but have fun with your friends while making these. There will be student leaders that can assist you if you run into any trouble. With your help, we can hope to make over 3,000 today.
Here in the auditorium, where you'll be watching several short videos that will hopefully inspire you, we'll be having a short Q&A after each film. Next stop.
The cafeteria, where you'll be painting stones with inspirational quotes. These stones will be placed in a rock garden near the rear student entrance. Here's a quick look at how this process will work.
Hey guys, today you'll be painting rocks that will go outside the cafeteria doors. You'll be given a template that will give you a list of inspirational and positive quotes. You'll have a white rock that's already primed, a palette, and a paintbrush. So choose a one quote that will go on your rock. And make sure to feel free to personalize the rock and make it your own.
After spring break, these stones will be put into place. Hands on!
Thanks! Hopefully you have a good idea of what you'll be doing today at each of the service stations. You'll be in each station for only 45 minutes, so be sure to listen when you get there and get to work. If you have any questions, feel free to ask your homeroom teacher.
Lunch will take place from 1 to 2 p.m. This is directly after you've gone through each service station. We will all eat at the same time, so you may need to claim a spot in the hallway near the front of the gym.
At 2 p.m., all of us will head into the auditorium to watch video highlights of what went on here at the school and what volunteers did while off campus. If we run out of seats in the auditorium, have a seat on the floor, or head into the cafeteria to view the video on the spirit wall. And at 2:30, we will head into the gym to watch this year's Macho Man volleyball game. Then,
spring break!
Thanks in advance for what each of you are going to do today. Look beyond yourself and serve another.
Hands on!